Hello children. Welcome back to my channel. Warning, this contains boy love. And if you don't like it, then please get off my channel. Water pistol, grinning face with cowboy hat. The Japanese national volleyball team was walking down the hallway together. They had yet another victorious match, and now they were heading towards their shared apartment. Light chattering was heard. Footsteps and laughing. They all had bright faces, except the one. They walked in groups: Hinata, Hoshumi, Komori and Yaku, the so-called short group. Bakuta's creativity walked in the front, simultaneously being the loudest and most cheerful ones. They talked about how cool the opposing team's ace was, and how strong his stud was. Right after them were Aaron and Bakuto, who would sometimes drop into the conversation, but mainly kept talking to Gayo and sometimes Wakatoshi and Sakusa. Wakatoshi and Sakusa walked in their preferred pace and distance from the others. They went at the end of the column. Yet they were somewhere in the middle. Hayakazura mainly kept to Iwazumi and coach, sometimes adding his own comments on others' stories and opinions, but mostly being quiet. And right at the end were the setters, both exhausted from having to run around with stamina monsters, and both ready to go to sleep. They weren't too far behind the others. Still, there was a certainly spacious distance between them and the rest of the team. Unlike the rest of their team, they walked mainly in silence, only speaking when asked. Atsumi wavered. He wanted to converse with the younger, but it just seemed as if something was off. It's not unusual for Tobio to be less talkative, but today something felt off. Their precious setter set the balls the way he always did. Precise and easy to hit, but still there was something wrong with him. His moves looked heavy, his eyes were half-lidded. He is tired, Atsuma's best guess, so Atsumi decided to let it go if tiredness was the case. Then that's nothing that a good night's sleep couldn't help with. They walked some more, the hallway looked as if it would never end. Throughout their walk, blonde man saw the hesitance in Tobias walk. His steps would stutter, and his legs seemed lazy. Nothing to be concerned of, right? It's just tiredness. Ayo. You too. Are you just gonna keep it slow like that, or are you gonna speed it up a bit? Hoshumi yelled at his setters. Ashijima said he's gonna make a b-balls. It's like a polished dish or something. Spare us. You were all beasts on the court today, Atsumu said as he rolled his eyes. You go on without us, we'll be there soon. Wouldn't miss the Shiwaka cooking for anything. He nudged Tobio with his elbow, only to get no real response other than a yawn. Okay. But don't complain when we eat all the food and don't leave anything for you, Hinata yelled, and he and Hoshumi ran down the hall, preferably to the national apartment. Not long after them, Yaku and Bakuto ran after them, and they all disappeared from sight. Do they even have the keys on them? The team's personal Grinch asked. I'm not quite sure, Kiyumi, hopefully they do, otherwise they will have to wait for us, Ashijima answered, as calm as ever. I do believe that Yaku has keys though. What airheads, hair, Totoku. Atsumu turned to his blue-eyed companion, only to realize that he wasn't next to him anymore. Then concern washed over him. Tobio was far behind him. His eyes were almost closed, his walking was slow, and his face was flushed. Hurriedly, the blonde man turned around to help his teammate. Hey, Tobio-kun, hey, are you okay? He asked as he put one hand to support the younger. Tobio stopped in his tracks, and had it not been for Atsumu, his pretty face would have collided with the hallway carpet. Whoa! Easy, Atsumu said and pulled him back, but this time he secured him in his arms. Tobio seemed to give up right there and then, and he fell face forward into Atsuma's shoulder. Not knowing what was the appropriate thing to do, Atsumu turned his neck to ask for support from his team, but once he did so, there was no one there. The hallway was empty and blurry, voices and shouts echoed, but he couldn't hear them quite clearly. The younger setter trembled in his arms, and his forehead felt burning hot against Atsuma's skin. Senior setter panicked. Never had he been in this situation before. He reached for his pocket to try to fish out his phone and call for help. He was an athlete, that was sure. But Tobias' body was taller and heavier than his own. He couldn't carry him in this condition all alone. Yet, the phone wasn't there, so he opted to look for Tobias' phone, which also wasn't there. Hang on, Tobio, Atsumu groaned, and then the blackout. He felt his blood rush, and his stomach felt empty as he forcefully sat up. His breathing was heavy, and he was sure he was sweating. It was a dream. Well, a nightmare, but it felt so terrifyingly real. Atsumu panted. He ran a hand trough his hair and down his face. Tobio was fine, his phone was on the nightstand if he needed urgent help. And it appeared to be 4 o'clock in the morning. He should really get back to sleep. Stupid dreams be damned. yet, after what it seemed like 20 minutes max of tossing and turning, Atsumu got out of the bed and searched for his slippers. Once he found them, he exited his bedroom thirsty. He went down the hall telling himself that he will only go to the bathroom, but he stopped walking when he was in front of Tobias Rowe. Not wanting to disturb his sleep, Atsumu pressed an ear to the door to make sure that the younger really was there, safe and sound, but after he heard nothing, the panic rose inside of him, and even if he knew it was sort of creepy. He opened the door to Tobias' room and quickly slipped in. As expected, raven-haired man was in his bed, sleeping. He could see that he was sleeping on his side, the blanket was rising with his every breath. And so, if he got this far already, he'd go along with the whole unplanned plan. So Atsumu tiptoed to the bed and carefully pressed the back of his hand to Tobias' forehead. It was at a normal temperature, which made Atsumu finally feel ease. He smiled softly and let a sigh of relief that he had no idea he was holding. Although he had never had a real chance to touch Tobio, well, at least not this direct, somehow his skin felt even softer than normally. Okay, now he was concerned for his own well-being. He shook his head and quietly hurried out of the room, but not before mouthing a barely audible "sweet dreams," because if Atsumu couldn't have nice dreams, hopefully the other setter could. Once finally outside, he pressed his back against the door. Everything was fine, it was just tiredness playing with his mind. Warning, this fanfiction does not belong to me, neither does the fan art. Credits to the original artist and author to the fan art and the fanfiction. Haikyuu does not belong to me either. Well, bye, children, smiling face with hearts.